Let me ask you a question. We always hear about protecting our daughters, our sisters, the women in our lives. But from whom exactly are we protecting them? Think about it for a moment. We say, don't go out late at night, don't wear certain clothes, don't talk to strangers, as if every danger in the world is something external. But the harsh reality is that too often the threat isn't a stranger lurking in the shadows. The threat comes from the very boys and men within our society, our own communities, our own homes. And that's the most heartbreaking part. It's not the girls who need more protection. It's our boys who need more education. We need to stop seeing women as something that needs shielding from the world and start teaching our boys that women are not objects, not prizes, not something that they have right to. Instead of telling our daughters what they should or shouldn't do, how about we tell our sons to respect women, to value them, to see them as equals? How about we educate them to understand that no means no, because respect isn't something that can be enforced through laws or candlelight marches. It has to be cultivated within the very fabric of our homes, in the way we raise our children. Here's a fact that should give us a pause. According to the National Crime Records Bureau of India, in 2022 alone, over 31,000 cases of rape were reported and over 88 cases of crime against women were reported every single day. These aren't just numbers, they are stories of daughters, sisters, mothers who were violated in the very society that promises to protect them. What are we teaching our boys? When we tell girls to be careful, aren't we indirectly telling boys that they are somehow dangerous? Shouldn't we instead be teaching our sons from a young age to be protectors of dignity, not violators of it? We focus so much on curbing the freedom of women, but where's the focus on curbing the behavior of men? The truth is, it's not our girls who need to live in fear. It's our society that needs to change how we raise boys. Boys need to be taught that masculinity isn't about dominance, power, or control over women. It's about kindness, empathy, and respect. It's about seeing women as fellow human beings, not something to be objectified or controlled. And this needs to start early. It begins in our homes and in our schools. Every time a boy hears his father dismiss housework as women's work, every time he sees his mother treated as lesser, every time we joke that boys will be boys, men will be men, we are planting the seeds for future disrespect and even violence. We are setting them up to believe that men are entitled to more freedom and power than women. Think about it. From a young age, boys are conditioned to think they are protectors and girls are conditioned to think they need protection. Why aren't we raising our children to see themselves as equals? Why is there such a deep-rooted imbalance in the way boys and girls are treated? The sad reality is that even today, in an independent India, most women don't feel truly free. They don't feel free to wear what they want, to go where they want, to work where they want, without fear of judgment or worse. We spend so much energy protecting women, locking them away, keeping them out of harm's reach, but we are not addressing the root of the problem. And that problem is a mindset, a culture, a belief system that places women lower than men. How can we call ourselves a free society when half of our population still doesn't feel safe? And the worst part, when something tragic happens, when a woman is violated, when her rights are taken away, when her dignity is shattered, too many people look for ways to blame her. Why was she out so late? What was she wearing? Maybe she was asking for it. But the truth is, no woman ever asks for it. No woman asks to be harassed, abused, or violated. The problem isn't with the women in our society. The problem is with how we as a society raise our boys to believe they have some sort of right over women's bodies, their freedom and their lives. So, the question, whom are we exactly protecting our daughters from? The answer is simple but painful. We are protecting them from the boys and men who haven't been taught to respect them. And that's on us. We need to stop treating this issue like it's something inevitable and start tackling it at its root. I know this isn't an easy conversation to have. It's uncomfortable. But we can't keep raising generations of boys who see themselves as protectors of women without first teaching them to respect women as equals. We need to instill values of empathy, kindness, and respect in our children. We need to teach them that consent is non-negotiable, that no one has a right to another person's body, and that every person, man or woman, deserves to live their life without fear. Because in the end, we cannot protect women by locking them away. True protection comes from changing the hearts and minds of the boys who will grow into men. It's not just about keeping our girls safe. It's about ensuring that our boys grow up to be the kind of men who would never dream of violating a woman's dignity. The change starts with us. Let's raise a generation of boys who don't just protect women, rather genuinely respect them. If you believe in this message, share this video. Because I refuse to stop. I won't be silent until this message reaches the hearts and souls of every person who hears it. This isn't my fight. This is a fight for every woman, for every girl, for every child who deserves a better and safer world. We have the power to change this, and it starts with us right here, right now. I will keep pushing, speaking, and standing up until we see real change in our society. Together, we can break the cycle. Together, we can build a future where respect, dignity, and equality are not just words, but the foundation of the world we live in. I won't stop until that day comes, and I hope you'll join me in this fight.